This video was made possible by Dollar Shave Club. Get your first starter set for just $5 at dollarshaveclub.com/HAI. This video is about bricks. Now, something you might not know about bricks is that they often have an indentation on one side, which is referred to as the frog. Among bricklaying enthusiasts, there's this big debate as to whether you should lay the brick frog up or frog down. If you go on bricklaying forums, you'll see endless spirited debate on frog orientation, and that really— okay, that should be enough to get the FBI agent assigned to my channel to click away. That was necessary because today, we're spilling some secret government tea. There are few certainties in life. Death, that Denver airport is home to the secret underground lair of the lizard people, and that snitches get stitches. Considering that's the case, you might want to figure out how to sew through plastic and inkjet cartridges, because your printer is tattling on you, and it's been doing so for years. Not only have printers been putting secret codes on every page for decades, but for over 20 years, nobody knew. Well, nobody except the government, that is. They definitely knew about it because that's the whole point. The codes are there to allow investigators to track counterfeiters. You see, back in the 1980s, a lot of things were happening. Rubik's Cubes were all the rage, walls were getting torn down, and people were sitting bored in their houses for hours on end because there wasn't a fast, free, and easy way to watch dozens of professional, high-quality videos about bricks. Also, the color photocopier was starting to get pretty popular, and when that happened, the world government, based in DC, understandably started to get pretty worried that people would use those color copiers to copy money. After all, before that, to copy money, you had to either have your own printing press or be really, really good at drawing George Washington's weird hair. The Xerox company wanted to assure the government that there was no way that someone would be able to use their copiers to copy money, so they secretly developed a way to include, on every single printed piece of paper, a map back to the source. The key? Tiny yellow dots. Still today, nearly every printed piece of paper is covered with tiny yellow dots that are so small, with a diameter of 1/10 of a millimeter, that they're almost invisible to the naked eye. They were intentionally made yellow so that when printed on white paper, nobody would notice them. In fact, even if you know they're there, the only way to see them clearly is to shine an LED light on the page and then look very carefully using a magnifying glass, which is probably why nobody noticed them for so long, because, like, why would you do that? That would be weird. But if you do, in fact, do that, you'll notice a bunch of dots that look randomly scattered across the page, but the placement isn't random at all. It's a code. When the public found out about these dots, it didn't take long for people to break the code and figure out exactly how these little yellow dots had managed to report so much information to the government. Here's how it worked. The dots were printed in a 7x15 grid, and each column represented something different, like the time, or the date, or the serial number. Under each column, a number was written in a version of binary code that used dots instead of ones. It can be a little confusing, but here's a breakdown. The numbers were represented by what's called a 7-bit counter that can represent any number between 1 and 127. There are 7 spots in a 7-bit counter, and each represents a different number: 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1. You put a dot or a 1 or something in a spot out of 7 to add that number to the total. So if I want to make the number 1, I would write 0000001. If I wanted to write 2, I would write 0000010. If I wanted to write 73, I would write 1001001. You can combine these numbers in a way to make every number up to 127. That's how these codes worked. Each column had a number that was spelled out in binary code. The first and fourth columns showed what time it was. The fourth column showed the hour, and the first column showed the minute. So in this example, the fourth column says add 8 and 4. That's 12. So we know it was 12 something. The first column says add 32, 16, and 2. That's 50. So we know the time the page was printed was 12:50. The next columns show the date. Column 6 showed the day, 7 showed the month, and 8 showed the year. So we know the day was 16 plus 4 plus 1, or 21. We know the month was 4 plus 2, so 6. And we know the year was 4 plus 1, or 5. In this case, 5 means 2005. And then columns 11 through 14 showed the serial number in reverse order. I won't do all the math over again because that was already enough for the week, but in this example, the serial number would be 21, 5, 28, 57. And nobody ever figured out what the 15th column does. So let's just assume that it's— these grids of codes aren't just printed once per page. They're printed about 150 times on each sheet of paper, but even still, nobody noticed these dots for 2 decades. But then, in 2004, rumors started to swirl, and PC World broke the news that your printer was a double agent. Now, we don't know exactly how many counterfeiters the government managed to catch in that time, but we do know, according to one counterfeiting specialist with the US Secret Service, that the codes have been, quote, extraordinarily helpful. You know what's also extraordinarily helpful? Always having a razor blade, stick of deodorant, tube of toothpaste, tub of hair gel, stick of chapstick, bar of soap, and every other grooming product stocked consistently in your home so you have it when you need it. Well then, it's dandiddly doodle good that Dollar Shave Club exists. How it works is that you build a box of every grooming product you need and then decide how often you want them to deliver it to keep you stocked. I tried their toothbrush and toothpaste, shampoo and conditioners, and shea butter and razor, and they were all really high quality. I probably had my cleanest and smoothest shave ever with their shaving kit. What's even more exciting than that, though, is that you can try them out by getting a starter set for just $5 only at dollarshaveclub.com/HAI, and you'll also be supporting HAI while you're at it.